In this lecture, we are going to study about generation and recombination, drifts and diffusion currents. This is lecture 5 of unit 2, semiconductor physics. So first we shall see what is generation and recombination. We already know that in a semiconductor, we have got the valence band and the conduction band, and they are separated by a small energy gap. When sufficient energy in the form of thermal energy or optical illumination is given to the semiconducting material, covalent bonds are broken and a pair of electron and hole is generated. The electrons are raised from valence band to conduction band, whereas holes remain in the valence band. The process of generation can occur only when the energy given to the semiconducting material is greater than its forbidden energy gap. The electrons move in the conduction band and holes in the valence band. Their motion is a random motion. The number of electrons is equal to the number of holes, as we have already seen in the case of an intrinsic semiconductor. When an electron in the conduction band collides with other particles, it loses energy and falls to the valence band. In the valence band, the electron combines with the hole, and in the process, energy is released. Recombination is the process where an electron from the conduction band recombines with the hole in the valence band. This is called band-to-band recombination, and in the process, a photon is released. So this picture over here shows you what is generation and recombination. So when sufficient energy is given, bonds will break in the valence band and the electron jumps from valence band to conduction band. And in the conduction band, when it collides with the other particle, the electron will lose energy and come back to the valence band and combine with the hole. Now, at a steady temperature, a dynamic equilibrium exists, which balances the two processes of electron hole pair generation and electron hole pair recombination. Next, we shall see what is drift current. Under the condition of thermal equilibrium, the electrons and holes are uniformly distributed in a crystal. And when no external field is applied, current does not flow in the crystal. So we can see what is drift current, the definition for a drift current. When an electric field E is applied to a semiconductor, the charge carriers, that is electrons and holes, start to move and produce drift current. We can see the expression for drift current. The electrons drifting in the conduction band produce a current component JE given by JE drift is equal to NE mu E into capital E, where mu E is the mobility of electrons. Likewise, the hole drifting in the valence band causes a current component JH given by JH drift is equal to PE mu H into capital E, where mu H is the mobility of holes. We can see what is the total drift current density. So the total J drift is equal to the drift due to electrons and the drift due to holes. That is equal to E into within brackets N mu E plus P mu H into capital E. Now it should be understood that although electrons and holes move in opposite directions, the direction of conventional current flow due to both the carriers is in the same direction. Next we can see what is diffusion current. The definition for diffusion current. In semiconductors, current can also flow without the application of external electric field. The charge carriers, once again electrons and holes, diffuse from regions of high concentration to regions of low concentration until the charge carriers are evenly distributed in the material. This motion of charge carriers produce a current component known as diffusion current. And we shall see expressions for diffusion current. The current component due to electron diffusion is given by JE diffusion is equal to E dE dN by dx. The current component due to hole diffusion is given by JH diffusion is equal to minus E dH dP by dx, where dE and dH are diffusion coefficients for electrons and holes respectively. The total diffusion current is JE diffusion plus JH diffusion, which is equal to E into dE dN by dx plus within brackets minus of E dH dP by dx. Now we can see a combination of drift and diffusion currents. The total current density due to drift and diffusion of electrons is equal to JE drift plus JE diffusion. That is equal to E into N mu E into E plus dE dN by dx. Likewise, for holes we have, it is JH is equal to JH drift plus JH diffusion, which is equal to E into P mu H into capital E minus of dH dP by dx. So in this lecture, we have seen what is generation and recombination, and also what is drift current and what is diffusion currents.